gay people. Two firsts. One, I've never vlogged before, so it might be awkward and I'm really sorry if it is. Two, a surprise. So, a little bit about myself. I'm out here as a drone pilot currently. I've done lots of different jobs in my life and this is a bit of a first for me. I'm flying drones commercially, inspecting wind turbine blades. So that's a first. Vlogging is a first. And this next thing is a first. So three firsts. Here we go. Finally, I've pulled the trigger. I was going to invest in one a year ago and I didn't. And then some exciting news came out. Some people loved it, some people hated it, but hey ho. It's made my life a lot easier. So without further ado, I would like to introduce to you the DJI FPV drone. Here we go. You guys are gonna get to watch me unbox this, as unboxing videos is apparently super popular right now on the internet. I've already unboxed it, I'm sorry, I couldn't wait. So yeah, let's get straight into it. FPV. I'm excited. I don't know much about FPV in terms of actual flying. I've watched lots of videos. I've got a fair bit of experience flying drones myself. Just flying drones traveling with my girlfriend. And then upgraded to commercial drone flying. Unfortunately, not in the film industry, but flying drones, inspecting wind turbines. So yeah, that's cool. It's fun. It's something different. I get to experience a little bit of the world, as you can see out here. Somewhere in the north of Sweden. DJI FPV. Exciting. Here are the goggles, as you can see. And the controller. So you guys, I'm going to bring you along with me through the ups and downs of FPV. I've heard it's very challenging. I've never had to go on a simulator. Hopefully I don't crash this drone first time and have to retire early from FPV. So we'll see. There's a lot of people out there that are doing incredible things, making it look easy. Hopefully I can do that too, with a little bit of trial and error and time. So yeah. So currently the DJI is updating, as you can see. By the flashing yellow lights, I'm pretty sure that means that in all DJI systems that an update's currently taking place. Just something that has actually really frustrated me and I've only just really worked it out. So I've just managed to get the update to work, fingers crossed, 96%, as you can see. So the issue I was having, which is crazy because I don't know why DJI would do this, but the way you update the system and activate it all, I should say activate, is by plugging this USB-C to USB cable into the DJI goggles, and then a USB to USB-C cable from the goggles into your phone, for example, or whatever device you're using to activate the drone. The drone needs to be on and the controller needs to be on as well, because it updates and activates the whole thing together. DJI send out a USB-C to USB cable. And after doing a little bit of research, finally found a video about the DJI cable only being a power cable and not a data cable. So for some reason, DJI send you out the cable that you need with the inability to actually activate and update your drone from. I don't know why this is, maybe to save money. I don't know. If anyone does know, leave a comment. I'd like to know. Seems very strange to me, especially when, you know, they've put so much time and effort into building this thing and, you know, it looks pretty cool. But yeah, so just me rambling on. Hopefully I've saved a few people some headaches. If you are going to purchase this FPV drone, do not use the DJI USB-C to USB cable. And also make sure that this little adapter, the USB-C to USB adapter, is plugged into the goggles, okay? And then the USB to USB-C cable is plugged into your device. Yeah, other than that, let's go. I'm ready to go. The drone's almost ready to go. It's still at 96%, so maybe I've jinxed it. Hopefully not. But let's see what happens in the next one. Here we go, people. Here we are. Test site. All ready to go. So, who's excited? Probably no one, because I can't imagine that anyone has got it this far through the video. But I'm excited. Let's give it a go and see what this FPV is all about. So because I'm in the north of Sweden, I had to double check on the DJI website to find out if this thing was waterproof, or at least water resistant, and the answer is no. Just no. No description, no yes this is water resistant, just no. So I've got myself a little landing pad. I don't know how this is going to go, but I'm going to give it a go anyway. Hopefully I don't land in the snow. I don't really have much choice. This is it. This is the north of Sweden in March, end of March. So yeah, if I was amazing FPV drone pilot, then no worries, it would be amazing, but this is probably going to be terrible. So hopefully there'll be some drama in a good way for you guys, and to make this video interesting and for great memories for myself. So without further ado, let's get this bad boy set up and see what happens. Let's go. So probably one of the coolest things about this drone, check this out. Hopefully you guys saw that. Pretty cool. Looks a lot better when it's dark, but yeah, sweet, here we go. Is that right? Do I look good? Any good people? What do you reckon? Hat on? Nah, it's not gonna work, is it? Pretty cool. Right, I think I'm ready. Fingers crossed, wish me luck. I have no idea how to fly this thing, by the way. Just so you're all aware. Hopefully it's the same as a normal drone. Ooh, test flight complete. That is not in manual. We've got a switch here. Yeah, that's in sport, so we'll see what sport does. It looks like it's exactly the same as any other DJI, so hopefully I should be able to fly this thing, and then maybe we'll give it a go manual in a bit. Okay. obviously it's not in manual mode right now, so it's pretty straightforward. The perspective is just completely different, obviously, because I'm there's no, so on a Mavic Pro, for example, Mavic 2 Pro, the gimbal will smooth out the video and keep the video feed, like, keep the horizon horizontal. Obviously, with this, you don't get that. It's more like, you know, you get roll and tilt through the camera. But it's cool, with the goggles on, you get like a really interesting sense of perspective. You can really see what's going on. You can see how close you are to things. Maybe not. Stop me there. Yes, pretty cool. I'm looking forward to flying it in manual mode. See if I can, see if I can get the grip to that. Because obviously in manual you can pull off some really interesting manoeuvres, as seen on social media and YouTube and all that by some incredible people. So here I am, crouched down like a little hobbit of some form. Oh, that's weird. That is so strange. I don't know why I'm crouched down. I feel like that's cool.
I'll stand up.
I was crouched down for the video, but I'll stand up. Oh, it's really strange. Like, when you move whilst you're wearing the goggles, it really throws you off.
Go see what the north of Sweden has to offer.
Okay, so I'm gonna call it there. Flight one, successful. I didn't crash it. I'm happy with that. That was fun. There she is. The DJI FPV drone going crazy at me because I'm so close. Getting a bit confident. Flight one complete.